and welcome to PC Pride inside of Paine College Sports. I'm the Mac Daddy, Charles McNeil. Happy to have you guys along for the ride, and we are excited about another season of college football. It's here on campus at Paine College, and it's really, really big, guys. You need to pay attention to this. And what better guest to have on our inaugural show than the head coach of Paine College. He joins us right now, Coach Greg Ruffin. Coach, congratulations on a fantastic start of the season, and more importantly, bringing football back after a 52-year hiatus.
Thank you, Charles. The guys have been working hard, and everyone's excited about being able to be thrust into this opportunity here in the CSRA area.
Well, for you in particular, this is nothing new. I mean, you've been around and been doing this for a minute, but for the folks in the community, after 52 years, I mean, think about it. We're talking about the 60s, and now football is back. What does that mean to you?
Well, it's an opportunity to establish a new tradition. It's an opportunity to bring the pride back. It's an opportunity to be able to compete, you know, in a sport that's so visible, you know, within the college landscape, and being able to bring that here to Augusta. I think that's big time.
And for you individually, obviously we've been seeing you doing your thing for a while in the college ranks. You're not a stranger to football.
No, I've had various jobs over the years, from Lincoln University in Missouri, where we started up football there in 99 after they dropped the program in 1988. Being over at Shaw University, starting that program up as the head coach in 2002 and going 7-3 in the first year. I've coached at Jackson State University in the SWAC Conference, and, you know, no stranger to the SIAC, as I've coached at Lane College, my alma mater, and Tuskegee University in 2005. So, you know, there's a sense of familiarity there, and I'm just excited to be able to get back, you know, in the SIAC with my own program.
Yeah, now let's talk a little bit about the recruiting part of it, because that's a major part. You had to get players to come in, and fortunately for us, you got some outstanding players, including local ones that are really doing big things.
Well, it was an opportunity for some local guys that had gone away, and I guess, you know, with some instances, some things weren't going their way, and guys wanted to come home and hey, they wanted to put their plow in the ground and help us, you know, get this thing off the ground and running, and those guys have done a great job. They bought in, and it gives us a sense of pride within the community, because we wanted to work this thing inside out, and what better way to do it than to get local kids, and, you know, that goes into play with your fanfare and getting people to the games and things of that nature.
Well, needless to say, we're excited about the start of the season. It's just around the corner, our third game already. I mean, it's amazing to me that it's happened so quickly. But let's look at these helmets and the uniforms, a unique design that you came up with yourself.
Well, I wanted us to look different. You know, from a recruiting perspective, I knew that would be something that, you know, could go into the allure of bringing guys here to Paine College. You know, these 18, 19-year-old guys, they look at the smallest things, and they mean so much to them. So you kind of have to stay up, you know, with the times as to what, the, you know, what really matters to them, you know. So I thought just adding the gray in as a third color and the black was a great, you know, spinoff of being able to, because everybody's adding the third color and the traditional and non-traditional black uniform that everybody's adding in. So I thought it was a good thing for us, and the kids are excited about the look.
Well, you've had one home game and one road game thus far. How do you feel about the crowd that came out to support you on Saturday?
Well, I just think, you know, they got excited. They stayed there with us, and as things evolved in the fourth quarter and it went down to the wire, they were pretty excited. And, you know, we was glad they hung in there with us. I think this thing is only going to get bigger and better from weeks to come.
Well, there's no doubt about that. Let's talk specifically about, you know, some of the things that you have coming up, including playing your alma mater. We'll get more into that in just a little bit, but really just talk a little bit about the SIAC and the competition that's involved there.
Well, you know, right now, you know, within the conference, you know, we have the leading passing offense in the conference, averaging 370 yards a game passing. So, you know, we have some little things that we need to work on, and by no stretch of the imagination, you know, are we there yet? And we understand that being in our infancy, but the kids are continuing to work hard, the resiliency is there, and we're working hard.
Well, it's obvious to me that you guys are doing big things, and I know folks are excited about that. And more importantly, I'm excited about the opportunity of what's up next. Stay right here. We've got much more on this program. You're watching Paine College Inside Paine College Sports, PC Pride, right here. Stay with us, everyone.
I don't know why I came in this club with you, girl. Don't know why I came in with the diamonds on my chain. Surrounded by
hard enough for me to play. Tell the truth, but she was you in this book that I was playing. So I'm just sitting in the studio just trying to get to you, baby.
This is PC Pride inside Paine College Sports, and once again, I'm the Mac Daddy. Coach Ruffin still joins us. Coach, as we prepare for the upcoming matchup, and we'll talk a little bit more about that matchup toward the end of the show, got to talk about the play of your quarterback, one of the outstanding performers in the conference after two games.
Yeah, Lorenzo Hammonds. He's a transfer from Florida International University, local high school superstar here at North Augusta High School. So it was good, you know, getting Lorenzo in the fold last year, to transfer back home after his redshirt year at Florida International. You know, he's had some phenomenal moments, you know, as he engineered that fourth quarter comeback last week and prior to that, you know, in Rome when we played Shorter University. But, you know, like I said, we, you know, got some things to work on. You know, like I said, we're a work in progress, as I said earlier. And just trying to be able to get the ball out of his hands a little quicker and trying to get him to run a little bit sooner instead of holding the ball. So you know, when it's time to run, it's time to run. So, you know, he's had a couple of turnovers that I think, you know, that I know he would want to have back. But other than that, he's kind of developing into his own. He's leading the conference in passing yards at this moment. But, you know, we're excited about his play and where this can evolve.
Oh, without a doubt. He also has a great core of receivers. And I'll tell you what, all of them were on full display in a 45-point display this past Saturday.
Yes, you know, Daniel Wabamuth has been phenomenal. He's number 12 for us. And Austin Bemis and Jabari Menifee and Dunn Quarles and, you know, all of those guys have done a good job. Antonio White, I can't say enough about them. That, you know, they've stepped up when their name was called, and they've allowed us to be able to be ranked in the conference in passing. You know, because the chemistry's there right now, and what we want to do is be able to shore up the protections even more, and so that we can continue to gel as a unit. You know, with our passing game and try to get our rushing game going.
Well, I was going to ask you about that next. Obviously, you said shoring up the passing with the offensive line starts there, and then also your running game helps to free up those guys to get downfield.
Exactly. We haven't been very viable running the football, and that's something that's our Achilles heel right now, and we're working on that in practice. You know, we have one of the biggest lines in the conference, but, you know, we're trying to be able to get those big, tall guys to bend over and push off that football and get some push. So, you know, it's one of those situations where we're trying to figure out, first, what are we good at? You know, if it's passing the football, then we're going to pass the football. You know, by no means are we going to continue to try to beat a, you know, dead horse in the mouth. If that's our forte, then we're going to take advantage of what the kids do well, and we're going to continue to try to excel at it going forward.
Well, the other thing is on the defensive side, they talk about defense winning championships, and maybe the fans may have expectations of great things. I don't know how you feel about the defensive performance after they opened 2 weeks this season.
Well, you know, we played very good against Shorter University. You know, we did a good job of, you know, stopping that triple option and bottling up a little bit. You know, they went on the road and beat a very good Mars Hill team and scored more points, you know, against an established program. So that goes to say a lot about what we have, you know, on that side of the ball. We just got to be able to come on with it. We got some injuries over there, and that was a product of having two linebackers out last week against Livingstone. It kind of hurt us. We kind of got out on our fifth guy linebacker, and it came back to hunt us a little bit.
And what about special teams? Are you pleased with the punting and kicking game?
I think we have one of the better kicking games in the conference. You know, our kicker is the number one kicker in the conference right now. Wisdom Azidia, a freshman out of Stevenson High School in the Stone Mountain area. So we're excited about where we're going with our kicking game.
More with Coach Greg Ruffin. This is PC Pride inside Paine College Sports. Stay with us. What it do, man? It's Band Magazine. You know, we in the building, man. Got some big things popping for the city. Augusta's number one hip-hop magazine.
For our city, not just for the individual. Shout out to yourself.
Now they
go in
the booth and they go hard.
Yeah, what it do? This your boy OJ the Jew, man. Mm-hmm.
You know the DJs.
Band Magazine.
Band Magazine.
What it do, man? It's your boy DJ Slide Take.
Band Magazine. We in the...
What up, it's your boy B-Nice Besides, little
quick. I'm just sitting in the studio just trying to get to you, babe. But the song's so f***ing dope, girl, it's hard not for me to play. Tell the truth, but she was you in this book that I was playing. So I'm just sitting in the studio just trying to get to you, baby.
PC Pride, Inside Paine College Sports continues with Greg Ruffin. Coach, you guys are just moments away from a matchup against a very tough Lane squad. What are your thoughts about playing them and obviously having to face your alma mater? It has to be somewhat bittersweet.
Well, Lane's, they're coming off a very good season last year. Lane was 6-4. I actually, they beat Albany State, who won our conference championship last year. They got a lot of new faces over there, especially at the quarterback position. They're coming in this football game 0-2 just like we are. Both of us, they're 0-1 in conference play, having lost to Clark Atlanta, and of course, it's our first conference opener. So, I'm excited about playing my school. You always say, you love your school, just except when they're playing me. And this is my third opportunity to play them in my 19 years of coaching. So, my biggest thing, it doesn't matter whether it's Lane or whoever else is, they just happen to be the next opponent, and we're hungry for a win.
Let's talk about some of the individuals that must step up for us to get our first victory.
It starts at the quarterback position for us. We've got to get some solid play out of quarterback position and continue to grow from week two to week three. Lorenzo Hammonds, coming off a 340-some yard passing to 370 yards passing last week, against Livingstone. We want to make sure that he continues to grow with his reads, and we got to limit the amount of mistakes to zero. We've had two big mistakes, over the last couple of weeks, as I said earlier, and we want to play smarter and harder this week at the quarterback position. Still get that same continuity at the receiver position with the guys like Daniel Wagamuth, who had a big game, who scored a touchdown in the last two games, and also with Austin Bemis. Austin was led us in receiving last year in our club season, so we're excited about those guys and what they bring to the table, and hopefully we'll be able to get the ground game going with Jarius Richardson, a freshman out of North Carolina, who's a solid running back, scored a touchdown last week.
Now, we didn't get a chance to talk about the defensive players by name, and you mentioned earlier that you had some injuries. Are any of these guys coming back, and in particular, who do you look for to step up on Saturday?
Well, our two starting middle linebackers are still out, and Travis Brown, he's still out. And Ryan Quarles, they're still out. They're banged up from the first game. Hoping we get those guys back. We're about 4 weeks out with Trey. He had a Jones fracture in the foot, so that's something where they'd put that pin in the foot and boot him up. And hopefully we get him back, by midway of the season. But you know what? You gotta be ready when your name's called. You gotta step up, and that's the name of the game. Next man up, and that's what we're expecting the young guys to do behind them. Just step up and make plays.
And talk a little bit about the special team, secondary rather, in particular your safeties and the guys that you count on to stop that passing game.
Well, last week, with our Daquan Richardson, he's our free safety. We got misaligned a couple of times, and we got hit with some big plays. Whereas the first game, we played a predominantly running football team, and this past week, we played a team that liked to mix it up a little bit, and it was a good barometer to see where we are, as a program back there on the defensive side of the ball. We had a couple of defensive linemen get banged up, but we're looking for the Henderson Wares of this world to step up, who's a big guy at 6'3", 320 pounds. We need those guys to come on with it. Of course, Tan Quarles had two sacks this past week, so, we're looking just to be able to get some pressure. Lane's a wide-open football team that they like to spread it out to run it, mix it up. So we're hoping those guys come to play this week.
All right, it's time for your keys to victory, Coach.
Well, we got to be able to get off the field on third down, and that's big defensively. We got to be able to manufacture first downs on offense, and we got to limit the number of turnovers that we had to a minimum of zero. If we do that, we think our efforts alone will be able to pull this thing out.
He's Greg Ruffin. He's the head coach. And, of course, this is PC Pride Inside Paine College Sports. Stay with us, everyone. Thank you so much, Coach, for being a part of the show. You did a great job in your inaugural visit with us on PC Pride, Inside Thanks. Paine College Sports. I'm excited about what we have ahead. I know you are as well.
I think, you know, we got a great opportunity to do something big, and we just want everybody to come out and support the football team this weekend. And as we continue to grow this thing and our traditions from our prior walk at 145 down in the state, and we're inviting everybody out to come down and walk down the street with the Lions as we head to Lucy Laney Stadium. And thanks for having me, Charles.